really get to decide that, does he, Jeffrey?
No, he doesn't. The jurisdiction that Mueller has, which he received from Rod Rosenstein last May when he was appointed, is very broad. It's basically Russian collusion. As written, that it's Mueller who gets to decide what's related or not. Keep in mind, though, that Donald Trump always has in his pocket the possibility of directing the Justice Department to fire Mueller. But in terms of day-to-day activities, it's very much up to Mueller what he investigates.
And we can put that up on the screen. Ron Rosenstein, when he appointed Robert Mueller, specifically said, and I will read this to you because it's worth reading every time, that he could investigate Russia, but also any matters that arose or may arise directly from the investigation. So if this arose during the investigation, fair game, at least according to Rod Rosenstein for Robert Mueller. Let's talk about the Abby Lowell denial, if we can. Abby Lowell, you know, a world-renowned attorney who defends a whole lot of very, very powerful people. He responded to this article saying that in all of Mr. Kushner's extensive cooperation with all inquiries, there has not been a single question asked nor document sought on the 6-6 building or Kushner company deals. This is a pretty broad denial, Jeffrey. You would think that the special counsel would be asking questions here if it were something he was seriously interested in.
Absolutely, and I think it's very much worth paying attention to what Abby Lowell said. It is also true that these investigations don't evolve immediately, and you certainly, if you are investigating a person, he's the last person you ask. He's not the first person you ask. But it's also true, if Mueller's people have not sought documents related to the 666 transaction, and I am sure there are thousands, if not millions, of documents related, that does suggest that this is not a focus for Mueller. But one thing I think we have all learned is that it is very difficult to predict where Robert Mueller is going. Last Friday's indictment was certainly a surprise to me, and I think to most people who've tried to follow the investigation. So I'm afraid Mueller has been very successful in keeping us all at bay, knowing about what precisely he's doing.
Collusion.
And Donald Trump over the years has said he only had very minimal businesses in Russia, very minimal business interests. You have a fascinating piece in the New Yorker today, and there's some intersection here with the whole Jared Kushner thing that looks into just what Donald Trump tried to do over the years in Russia and deal specifically with the Miss Universe pageant. What did you find? What was most interesting to you?
Well, one of the things that's so extraordinary is that Donald Trump's interest in Russia go back to the days of the Soviet Union. You know, he went there in 1987 trying to make a deal when the communists were still in charge. And, you know, if you want to talk about collusion, the single most obvious example of collusion so far, the June 2016 meeting in Trump Tower with Jared Kushner, with Paul Manafort, with Donald Trump Jr., was directly set up because of connections that Donald Trump
with
made
Russia.
During the Miss Universe contest in 2013. That is the most direct evidence of collusion that has been produced so far. It goes to Miss Universe, and Miss Universe is just a bizarre story in and of itself. Donald Trump personally chose the finalists, not the judges. How about that for a scoop?
Thank you,
as
Kevin.
As they often say, all rose
to Miss Universe.
Jeffrey Toad.
All rose to Miss Universe.
Thank you so much for being with Jeffrey. I appreciate it. Join me now.